Hello and welcome to another uMake tutorial. My name is Nico, and in the next couple of tutorials I'm going to show you how you can quickly create a nice looking chandelier. So let's jump right into it. The first thing I want to do is create the center part of the chandelier, and so to do that I'm just going to draw a curve as close to the vertical axis, the y-axis, as possible, and I'm just going to kind of make some curves and some sharp points. Now keep in mind, uMake's going to try and clean this curve up, but if you can get something that looks like that, then you'll be pretty good. You can always tap on this curve once to show the control points, and you can edit this curve to get to a desired shape. I'm actually pretty happy with how this came out, and I'm going to use the snap to grid to make sure that that snaps to the grid, and make sure that this one snaps to the grid. So the endpoints, as long as they're snapped to the grid and they are right on the y-axis, that'll make the next step easier. Once you're done editing, tap the green check mark, and our curve is now ready to be transformed into a revolved surface. So I'm in the front view now, and I'm going to double tap the curve, and I'm going to tap revolve, and I have a nice revolved surface. Since the axis is already on the y-axis, because I snapped the center points there, I don't need to adjust the axis. So I'll tap the green check mark, and I am done with that part. Now for the next step, I'm actually going to go to the side view. And the reason I'm doing the side view is I don't want to intersect one curve with the curve we drew this with. Otherwise, that will take away the revolved surface. So I'm going to now draw a spiral shape, something like this. That should work. And again, you can come in and you can edit this if you want. So I'm just going to edit this just a little bit. And I'm just going to move this in and down. I'll move it up. There we go. And from that spiral shape, I'm actually going to double tap it once, come over to extrude, go to the top view, and I'm going to do a two-way extrude. Just make kind of a thin band. There we go. That's about good. Doesn't have to be too thick. Pretty thin is okay. Tap the green check mark, and now I have this kind of metallic spiral. So that looks pretty good. The next step is I'm going to draw another curve under the spiral. So something like this. And I'm going to edit this again. Let's see here. And this is actually going to be where the lamps attach. So that looks pretty good. I'll pull this down and pull this over. Actually, something like that. Pull this part down just a little bit. And I'm actually going to move the spiral up just a tad bit. And then move this curve up. There we go. This is looking pretty good. Now I'm going to go to the top view and just draw a little circle. Oh, there we go. Get rid of the surface, double tap on this surface, and tap erase. All right. I'm going to scale this down, make it kind of small. And then I want to bring this circle down kind of towards the bottom of this lower curve that we drew. There we go. And I'm going to go to the bottom view, and I just want to center that over. Uh-oh. That's okay. Center that over this, like that. And what I'm going to do here, I'll double tap on the circle, double tap on this curve here, go to extrude, then tap along path, and then grab this little yellow dot, and I'm just going to extrude this along the path. And we have this nice extrusion. Once I'm done with that, tap the green check mark, and in just a couple minutes, we have the beginning of a nice looking chandelier. You'll see in the next tutorial, the next lesson, it's going to start looking really cool once we do a couple more additions to it. So that's it for step one. If you have any comments, questions, or feedback, definitely let us know on our YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter channels. We can't wait to see what you make. Have a great day, guys. Bye-bye.